All right, time for this week's high score challenge game. It's actually one I've been looking forward to for this series for quite a while, so it's nice to see it pop up. Yes, Fantasy Zone, that very cute looking but deceptively hard shooter for the arcade by who else but SEGA. So yes, it's right up my alley, because we all know how much I love SEGA. And I have played this quite a lot, and luckily I've gotten better at it than when I first played it. I've also played quite a lot of the other ones too, like Super Fantasy Zone and all that, so that should help me. Also, I did a practice beforehand, and it actually went pretty good, especially the score. So I'm hoping I can at least do a little bit better than what that turned out, and I'll be happy with it. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go for it. Of course, as always, one credit, no more. Two things. One, I'm going to be doing a little grinding, not for points actually, but for money. It's kind of necessary. It'll be a little bit slow, but it's needed. You'll see what I mean. There's a reason for it. But it's secondary bonuses score, of course, so that's not a complete waste of time. The other thing is, I'm actually going to be fighting the first boss with no upgrades, which sounds kind of crazy, but it's actually not. It's perfectly doable. And again, I have a reason for it. It's all part of my strategy. All right, so let's get to it. And it's got some really good music. Yes, you play as Appa Appa. Now, I've mentioned this so many times because I've done many videos on different versions of Space Harrier, but I'll mention it again here. For whatever reason, SEGA decided to make kind of a crossover between this series and that one, in that Space Harrier takes place in the same world and universe as this verse. The only time SEGA ever did anything like that. Here's another weird thing. Overall, Space Harrier is just, in general, harder, but I'm better at it. I don't know why, I just am. Always have been. I do kind of like Space Harrier better, so... I know EdTLM38, he loves Super Fantasy Zone. Now, the unfortunate thing for me is not all these enemies drop money, so... the other ones are just gonna be for points, and a nuisance. My goal here is not to lose a single life until I beat the first boss. Meaning, after I beat the boss, you know. I can't guarantee I'm gonna beat the second boss, though, as ridiculous as it sounds, but he's hard. He's got ridiculous fucking patterns, especially if you can't move fast enough to dodge. Even then, if you move too fast, you might not be able to move in the right spot to avoid getting killed, so that's a problem as well. Now, I never memorized exactly how much I need. I know I need at least 5,000 money, so, yeah, that's what I'm going for right now. Damn, he got away. These guys are great. They don't do anything to you, and they drop a shit ton of money, every single one of them. I love it. Well, when you kill the boss, you get a lot of money too, but that's when you beat the boss. Alright, here's where things are starting to get bad. If you hang around too long, enemies will start swarming and shooting at you. And increasingly more and more powerful shots, so... while you don't have a time limit, and they kinda... I always thought they kinda intended you to, you know, do this to grind for money. But you don't want to do it really long. Unless you're just some kind of god at it, you know? It's like Bosconian. The longer you stay around, it's lucrative, but dangerous as shit. Fantasy Zone might look cute and all that, but it's fucking dangerous, man. It really is. Alright, I'm good on money, so I'm gonna bring out the boss, which obviously you do by killing all the enemy spawners. Alright, I'll get a few more of these coins. It's also points. You don't get any points for the money in this, but it's still worth to do it anyway, just in case. You might be making an unscheduled visit to the store. Which, unlucky for me, I might need the store to appear after it goes away the first time in the second stage, but it might not happen. I got that kind of bad luck. Alright, can I get this last coin? Yes, I can. Alright, boss time. He's not hard at all, just... you gotta be paying attention is all. He's nothing compared to the second boss. This guy's just a matter of paying attention is all. Yes, it would go faster if I had weapon upgrade, but you don't need it, really. Again, part of my strategy, save money. Use it for what I really need. There we go. That's it. And now get as many of these coins as I can. Oh, came a little shorter than what I usually get, but it's alright. Yes, store. Good. Okay. Now. I'll be getting the jet engine. If I die, I lose it. I'll be getting the wide beam. And... extra life. Notice how much they crank, they triple, or quadruple, actually, the price of it once you buy it the first time. Yeah. Yeah, yes, I could have bought a few more things, but I'm saving my money. Now, the jet engine is good on, like, the stupid wings because it doesn't have a time limit. Like, some weapons, you have a, like, a power limit to how long you can use it for. Jet engine doesn't. So long as you're not stupid and die, you'll always have it. I don't need to explain how beneficial it is in a shooter to be able to move fast and dodge, you know. It's one of those kind of things. That and I'm just used to playing shooters that move fast. That's another reason I kind of have to do it. I remember Super Fantasy Zone, actually, you move a little faster by default. It's been a while since I played it. These things take a lot more hits than the last spawners. I can't say I'm a fan of that either, but, you know, whatever. Now, the problem here is I might be moving a little too fast. I might actually end up not being able to dodge the second boss's pattern. That happens, but this is really to help me here. Yeah, so I have bombs, but I never use them. It's just, again, how I play. I don't find them particularly useful. Most of the time. Later on, I have more use for them, but right now I don't. In case you're wondering. Also, yes, you can walk on nothing. You gotta kill all of them to just drop one coin. What the fuck? Game, you make no sense sometimes. Sometimes, I mean, most of the time. Look at this shit. It's like what you see when you're on shrooms. A lot of Sega and Nintendo games look like that, so... Hey, you never know, maybe they were in shrooms. Alright. Whoa. Don't want to lose my engine just yet. Actually, I don't want to die in general just yet. All the chances I have to fight the second boss, I won. Again, it's a hard game, man. I ain't kidding. It's awesome, but sometimes it's as frustrating as Ikaruga. Now, I'm not actually grinding for money. I'm just trying to move forward without dying. But I gotta take them out so they're not behind me as I'm trying to shoot the... Well, you see what I'm doing. Do I really need to explain? Hopefully he's gonna turn around on me. Alright, get the slimes from Dragon Quest out of here. I'm getting tired of them. Alright, one more to go, and then fight the boss. Here's what I was talking about. I wanted the sword to show up again, and it's not. Technically, I could probably kill myself to make it appear, but I don't want to do that. I'm not losing my lives. I need them. Alright, here's the thing I was talking about. His pattern is fucking nuts, and I probably am moving too twitchy to actually accurately dodge. We'll see. Oh, maybe not. I gotta focus. Yeah. I was trying to move a little bit to the left so I can get between that gap. Not happening. Oh boy, this is turning out exactly like it usually does. I'm trying, guys. Let's see. I just don't move fast enough. Oh man. Damn it! I keep forgetting you can't move that far off to the side on the screen. Son of a bitch. I hate this boss. Ugh. Awesome mute boss music, though. His face is how I feel right now. Oh my crap, I made it. I don't know how. Seriously, I am fucking proud of that. Oh, I had no engine upgrade and I did it. Oh, yeah. Sorry, I have to personally take a little happiness with that one right there. I'm proud of myself. I will be buying bomb upgrades this time. Can't afford that. I'm okay with that. I gotta hurry up. Seven-way shot. It's useful, but not as much as you might think. Yeah, I'm done. Wow, this is going better than I thought it would. Shit. Yeah. I'm good. Alright. These take even more hits to kill. It's been a while since I played it. Also, they look like cameras. Yeah, you see what I mean? How this has got a power meter until you can't shoot anymore with this weapon? That's what I meant. If you use the wings, it's very limited. Whereas if you get the engine like I just bought again, you can just keep using it. Again, so long as you don't die. That's the trade-off. Costs a lot more, but it lasts so long as you don't die. Ooh. Oh man, I should have just... I should have dicked around and killed a little bit more. I could have got some more money. Yeah, I only need a little bit more than I can... I want to get another extra life, because I want to prolong this as long as I can, man. Oh. Yeah, I ain't that bad at the game. You gotta do a little bit better than that. Bring it on, fuckers. Bring it on down to my house, come on. Yeah. Again, I have no idea what half this shit's supposed to look like. It looks like floating robo camera fish things right there. Now I'm mashing both attack buttons. I need all the help I can get. I got a bad feeling I might not get to the next boss. It's one of those levels to me. It feels that way. They're not giving me enough of a break I can sit there and shoot the spawner. Alright, this one's dead. There you go. I'm so glad there's no time limit in this game. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I don't want to die here. I just bought an engine again. Just go away. Let me shoot the target, the objective, whatever. Get out of here. It only gets harder and harder to kill those fangs as it goes on. They take more and more hits. Oh, no. And I bet the store's not going to show up again. Oh, wait, there it is. Oh, I got it. Oh, I'm so close. I could just... I'm not wasting any more money. Oh, I should have bought a better weapon. Screw it. Oh, look at that. It puts me right in front of enemies. Thanks for that. I really appreciate that. That was fantastic. Really being a dick game. Doesn't want to play fair. That's okay. I'm wise to its tricks. Just kill it. Ugh. There you go. I think this game is fuel for nightmares, really. At this point, it just loses the cute factor and just goes to fucked up imagery factor. Alright, what's left? Oh, shit, I'm fighting the boss. Okay. I don't remember his pattern right now. My memory kind of... Yeah. My memory blanked. I forgot that's what he does. Oh well, doesn't matter. I lasted longer than I thought I would, man. Maybe I should have just sat around and grinded more. Shit, I could have got 100,000 points. I was so close to it. That one death I had in the second world shouldn't have happened. And if it didn't, I would have lasted a little longer, could have killed a little bit more enemies, had a little bit more money, could have bought an extra life. Oh. But you know, I'm very happy with how this went. I even got to the third boss. I just couldn't remember what his pattern is. So that's my fault, I meant. But anyway, there you go. That's my final score. I'm honestly very happy with that. Thanks for watching. And I will see you later. I love that game over theme.